In this video, I teach you a steam stop valve, function of steam stop valve, construction and working of steam stop valve. So it is a one of the mounting of a various boilers. Okay, so what is the function of steam stop valve? So this is the image, but we understand this image during the construction and working. So first we only focus on the function. So its name is suggest that to stop or control the flow of steam in a boiler. So in a boiler, the function is to generate the steam. So at the outlet of the steam, means it is a top part of the our boiler cell. So it is installed in a top part of the boiler cell. Okay. So it is used to regulate the flow of the steam from boiler to the steam pipe. So in a boiler, steam is collected from the boiler through steam pipe. It is supplied whenever to required. Okay, so it is generally used to regulate the flow, means how quantity of the steam is supplied. It is decided by using this steam stop valve. Okay, now next we moving towards construction. Before that, I request to like the video and subscribe the channels for watching the more video. That is, a number of videos is available related to mechanical engineering and the basic of mechanical engineering. So I request to watch the playlist. Okay, for a various video. Now here it is a construction. So in a construction, we study how many component is there. The flange of valve body bolted to the boiler at the highest part of the steam space. So as earlier I tell that the steam stop valve is connected with the topmost part of a boiler because the steam is collected in the upper part of a boiler cell. So this valve flange, where is the valve flange? Here you see that, here the valve flange. So it is connected with the boiler's cell. It consists of a valve seat and nut. So here you see that it is a valve seat. On the valve seat, the valve is seat. Okay, that's why it is known as the valve seat, means it is a seat for a valve. That's why its name is valve seat. And the main body of the valve is made of the cast iron, means this outer body of the valve is made of the cast iron, and valve seat is made from a gun metals, means this portion is made from a gun metal. The lower end of the spindle connected to the valve and upper end passed through the glide and yoke and connected with the hand wheel. So this vertical portion is known as the spindle. Okay, so one end of the spindle is connected with this valve and another end is connected with the hand wheel. Okay, in between the spindle is passed from the glide and this nut. The function of the glide is to avoid the leakage. The glide is used to prevent the leakage of the steam because steam is come here. So it is a possibility that from the space of the spindle and the body, it is steam is going out. So the glide is prevent the leakage of the steam. So here this round is indicate the glide. When steam stop valve is placed directly over the boiler and connected to the steam pipeline, then it is called as the junction valve. And if it is placed near to prime mover, then normally called as a steam stop valve. So it is installed near the turbine and the another prime movers, then it is called as a steam stop valve. But it is only connect the boiler with the steam pipe, then it is known as the junction valve. So next we move towards the working of steam stop valve. The spindle is rotated by help of the hand wheel. So its name is hand wheel, means this wheel is operated by hand. It's either moving the clockwise direction or either the anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so suppose we moving this hand wheel in a clockwise direction, at that time the spindle is moving in upper direction. When we moving in anti-clockwise direction, spindle is moving in downward directions. And on the another hand, the valve is connected. That means we rotate the handle, then valve is moving in up and down directions with this moment of the spindle. So due to this rotation of the spindle, the valve is either move up or either the down. That is a two possibility depending upon the direction, either clockwise or anticlockwise. When the valve is seat over the valve seat, means this valve is seated on the valve seat, at that time passage of steam is completely closed, means that is a no space for a steam to go at outlet. Here it is a steam inlet, here the steam outlet. So when the valve is on the seat condition, no steam is supplied towards the outlet. The steam passage may be partially or fully open by moving the valve up, help of the rotating the hand wheel. So we moving this hand wheel clockwise direction, and spindle is moving upper direction, and valve is also moving upper direction. So there is a certain space is open here, that is either fully open or partially open, depending on the requirement, the steam is supplied towards the outward direction. The clearance between the valve and valve seat regulate the flow of the steam out of the boiler. Means there is a certain clearance between the valve and valve seat, it regulate the flow of steam out of the boiler. So it is generally in locomotive boiler, means the locomotive boiler is earlier used in a train. The train is run by the steam engine. Okay. In a locomotive boilers or in a train, the supply of the steam is regulated by means of the regulators, which is placed inside the boiler cell and operated by the handle from a driver cabin. So in a train is run by using the steam engine at that time. Driver is operate this handle. Okay. So for running the train at the high speed, we require the more steam. So it's open the this valve by using the handle, then train speed is increased. If we just stop to the train, then what? They are close the valve by moving this hand wheel. Okay. So that is used in a locomotive boilers, and also in other boilers they are used. So thank you for watching this video. If you learned, then like the video, subscribe the channels and share with your friends.